Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making a complete meal in a bowl. This is going to be chili, beans, and rice. And what we're going to need is one can of chili beans. This is about 15 and a half ounces, or 16 if you find that. We need a can of beef broth and a can of beef bouillon. Those are soups, clear soups, dark soups. They are 10 and a half ounces each. We're going to be using some white rice. You can use any kind of white rice. This is long grain white rice, and all we need will be one cup. We're going to use some chopped onions. These are dried onions, and we're going to use a quarter of a cup. We'll need chili powder. Actually, the chili beans are spiced already. They have chili powder in them, and that's why I choose them over just regular pinto beans or something like that. But we want some extra spice, so we're going to add one tablespoon of chili powder. We'll be finishing up with some melted margarine. This is one half of a stick, so you need to melt that. And we turn our oven on to 375 degrees, or somewhere in that vicinity. It can be 350 up to 400, depending on your oven. So I'm going to start by placing the chili beans in this Pyrex bowl. You need an oven-proof bowl, and it doesn't have to be any particular type of bowl or any brand. It just needs to be big enough to hold all of these ingredients and fit in your oven. So we get that, and then it's easy to pour in the beef broth and the beef consomme. The cup of white rice goes next, and the order really is not important. That's just what I have placed in this order. And then we put in the chopped onions. That's one quarter of a cup. For spice, we have one tablespoon of chili powder. Just dump that in. And then I've already melted the margarine over here on the cooktop, so I'm just going to add that in. You can see most things can be just poured in. You don't really have to spend a lot of time spooning things except for the chili beans. When you get to this point, you're going to stir this all together. And it's going to be very liquidy because the rice will expand, and that's what's going to give it its texture at the end. But when you get it to this point, what you need to do is cover it with some aluminum foil, which I've already cut off.